the wood out the roof. Jim.
It's one of them ones, man. You just in the car, man. It's like when you in the car, you just think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to traffic. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young with money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I wanna do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving fast to slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions, gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision, keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit, it's been a while. I've been working, she keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing a house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving, ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gonna come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of me.
All right, Coach, EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Sunshine State in TIAA Bank Field here in Jacksonville. A few minutes prior to us coming on air, this crowd was jolted into action with the introduction of these Jaguars. They're set for football as the Jags are ready to match up with the Washington Redskins. It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Fournette, 1,000-yard rusher from a year ago. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They keep it with Fournette on first down. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the football. And the plays he's making, he's spilling them in the offensive backfield.
And he'll get that to Fournette complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs. In Washington territory now, here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll fake it. Now Rudolph. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, give yourself your best chance to win.
So he's got daylight. 20. Touchdown, Jaguars. Boston Scott, his second touchdown on the season. And the Jags have taken the early lead. You talk about explosion plays. There's one pretty much right out of the gate.
And now they get to ride a wave of emotion, momentum, everything. Just as you described, right out of the gate, big sprint, touchdown. They're excited. But on the other side, they've got to guard against a major letdown, because they hit them right in the gut with that one. And now you start to question yourself a little bit when you give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Smith and the Redskins will come up now, first and 10 at their own 21. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for Crowder, and it's intercepted. A.J. Boye with a pick. And they're going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down the score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
First down carry. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And that was a good run. This was only one of nine guys to go over 1,000 yards in 2017. And I think you can't let him run wild here.
What do you think, 100 yards, the measuring stick?
Always. That is the threshold. You want to keep him under that if you want to play good defense.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. They'll get about six there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line. Now, look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
Second down now. Scott. And oh, he coughed it up.
Wow. That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Rudolph looking to throw. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
So following the holding call, what can they do here on third and long?
No. Check. Patriot! Patriot! Gone! All right, now, lucky 56.
Here's Rudolph. He's got the hookup to Lee. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Green 80.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Tackle made there by Zach Brown.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
On second down, here's Rudolph. And it is caught at the 7-yard line. And here he'll get it down to the 7. A gain of 4 on the play. And just like that, it's third down. Shotgun snap for Rudolph. He rifles one that's intercepted. Monte Nicholson picks it. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
This is the first carry for Rob Kelly. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
That's caught by Kelly. And they'll get him down here at the 23. It's a gain of 5, and they're going to face a 3rd down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now a former Seminole. This is Chris Thompson. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down. So on 4th down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman. And he'll take this all the way down inside the 40. Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number 2. They take over 1st and 10 following the interception. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. After the interception, here's Smith. Complete. Richardson has it. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
They'll fake it. Now Smith. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
Tremendous field position there and a perfect time to do exactly what they did. Take a shot at the end zone. And they went for the big play, just unable to complete it.
Smith now to throw. Jordan Reed has it. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
They brought in the heavy set on third down, and that usually means running play, but we have seen them throw out of that formation. And sure enough, they snuck the tight end out on that one, wound up hitting him for a first down.
They'll hand it off to Kelly. They stopped after only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
Now it's Smith off the bootleg. They'll roll him out right. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. The gain of 5 that time gives him the conversion and makes it first and goal.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third
and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Chris Thompson, his 6th touchdown of the season. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game. So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. To return it is Corey Grant. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And last time, 1-play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a 1-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give him a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
A big run by the big man Fournette, 47 yards on the ground. And you talk about great blocking up front. I don't think he was even touched, not a finger on him, until he was brought down to the ground.
I think we heard the whoosh as he went by, didn't we? Right through the gap. No one there, as you outlined, no one touched him at all. A free sprint into the secondary.
Yeah, that's what you call breaking free right there. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
Rudolph throwing on second down. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's a give to Fournette. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the three.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow. Not the tie, but yeah.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. Smith and the Redskins will come up now first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They go play action here on first down. Jaguar pressure.
pressure and a Jaguar sack. Calais Campbell in there to get him, and that's sack number 6 for him on the year. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Smith. Airing one out for Crowder. He's got a man complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. That one goes for 36 yards. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Again, this is Kelly. And a decent game there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Jacksonville. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back after this.
On.
They'll run with Thompson. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
And he'll get this one down to about the 27. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
They'll try the air now with Smith. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
The Redskins on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Play action. It's Smith. Now he steps away, and he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And that is no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So they'll come away with nothing here. A disappointing result even on a day like this.
And as a kicker in the rain, you've got to slow things down a little bit. Give your holder an extra half second to make sure everything's secure. And here, he might have rushed this one a little, and it winds up no good.
They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
Back 99 Philly, here we go! Watch him now, Barney!
On second down, here's Fournette. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it, as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. The Jaguars on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time it's 3rd and 3.
Over. Hot.
Out of the gun, Rudolph. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are
season
in December.
Of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it. So those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. And he drops this off to Thompson, complete. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and they're going to have a third down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for them.
Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. And now the Jags going to signal for another timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. The running back, Leonard Fournette, his intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And that didn't fool anybody. He's going to be dropped in the backfield. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. Here's Rudolph off play action. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. Thought they were going to force a fourth down. Instead, P.I. gives him the first.
And that's frustrating because you think you've taken them really deep into the count, haven't you? Instead, you've got to start all over. That could really, really be demoralizing.
So we hit the halftime break here in Jacksonville with the Jags on top. As we send you a couple hours south of here to Orlando, that's where we check in with a coach and our EA Sports halftime report. This is taken at his four. And a nice job there as he gets this one up just shy of the 35-yard line at the 34. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that rests. Looking for his tight end read, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey, and he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Detroit! Detroit! Gone, gone! Gone, gone! Now let's go!
After the interception, here's Rudolph. He's going to air one out. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it.
Here we go. 319! 319!
Hand off to Fournette. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Again, it's Fournette. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. Off the corner. Where'd he come from? Well, I guess he came off the corner, but really nice play.
I like when you're able to pose a question and answer it at the same time. That's exactly where he came from, but it's not something that you normally see. Most of the time, we're thinking about those guys covering pass catchers. In this case, he was a big factor in a run game. No game.
Throwing on 3rd down, here's Rudolph. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. A great effort there. His 14th touchdown now on the year. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. Here's Lambeau out to kick this one away. This one fielded at the 5. Gets around him. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And following the interception, interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down. That 1st down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7. A shotgun snap for Smith. And his throw is incomplete.
This has been a really nice day for the defense. They've made it so difficult to find open receivers because they're able to squeeze the passing lanes down. A lot of what they're doing is communicating. Receivers in one area, receivers in another area. They're almost what they call passing them off from one defender to the next, even in zone defenses, and making it very hard to find an open spot for the quarterback to deliver the ball.
Throwing on 3rd down, Smith. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Well, we're into the 2nd half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. Fielded at the 33. Look at the spin.
Balance.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense. 1st down and 10. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? Or they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, you think you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still 3rd quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. 8 yards there on the carry, and now they're left with a much more manageable 3rd and 3. The Jaguars on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3.
All right, here we go. Boom, landed.
They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the 1st. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot has been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. They'll run on 1st down. Scott, and he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. It's Rudolph, forced out to his left. Over the middle, complete. It's Cole. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Here's a carry for a former starter. This is T.J. Yeldon. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Fournette. And he gets stopped up at the 31 after a gain of maybe a yard. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
The Jaguars on third down. They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 10.
From the gun, here's Rudolph. And that is incomplete.
Boy, the numbers throwing the football just not trending in the right direction. Last week he was under 50%. He's under 50% again here.
And we haven't gotten an announcement, but it appears to me that he might be a little dinged up and is just trying to play through. You know, he's one of those tough guys that wants to answer the bell each and every play for his team. That might be throwing off his accuracy.
I tell you, it's not easy kicking field goals in the best of conditions. Yet in a downpour like we're in right now, it makes it that much harder. And sure enough, they can't convert here.
Smith and the Redskins will come up now first and 10 at their 38. Now Thompson. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just
means... And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. So their woes on offense continue. That's the second pick thrown here in the third quarter.
And we know it was ill-advised, but that was an opportunity to help them get back into the game. Instead, he throws another interception, and now their task is even tougher.
Set! Green, 39! Green!
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back.
Here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
They'll run it again with Fournette. He's going to be out of bounds on what's going to wind up being the final play of quarter number three.
The Jaguars on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. They need just a yard here. It's third and one.
Set! Green, 39! Green, 39!
Hey, pick it up, defense. Let's go.
Shift.
Now Leonard Fournette. And he'll be stopped up quickly here at the 38. Give him a yard on the play, and he's definitely short. It'll be fourth down and a few inches. On is Josh Lambeau now for the Jaguar field goal. This to make it a 3-score game late. And no, it doesn't get there. Hits the crossbar, bounces back out. He had it online, but it comes up about a rotation short.
Smith and the Redskins will come up now first and 10 at the 45. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
So that's caught at the 25. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10.
They'll run it now out of the gun.
And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Here's Smith. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. But tapping those toes, he tried to get both in bounds. He could not do it, though.
In tap dance parlance, could not complete the shuffle. All right, needed to get that shuffle down with both feet, not just...
Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sack back at the 29.
Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
And now with the play clock winding down, Jason Garrett opts to take a timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it.
Tiger.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. And no, it's incomplete. Jason Garrett might be wanting to reconsider. Decision to go for it there. And the Jaguars are going to take possession here on the turnover on downs. They begin with a run by Fournette, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and it'll bring up a second and 13. They'll run it now out of the gun, and he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a third and 13.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Third and long, it's Rudolph. Completes it to Lee. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
They didn't get the first down, but I have to say I do like the call. I like what they were trying to do. Try and hit your receiver on the run and see if he can pick it up. Keep it on his feet, get a little rack yardage.
Yeah, but a nice job defensively to get to him and keep him short of the first.
And this one hits at the 1, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. And here come the Redskins now. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number 1 headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
up. But
he
trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. After the incompletion, they'll try once more from the 20-yard line on 2nd and 10. On 2nd and 10, Smith. Docks it with a grab over the middle. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. He got 29 yards that time. On 1st down, it's Smith. Airing one out for Crowder. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my. He pulled it in. Touchdown, Washington. Jamison Crowder hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Redskins have made this a one-score game. This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Here's Corey Grant now to return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go.
Now, the previous drive they punted, but that was just the first time they've had to do so in this game.
And when they turn on the game film, the coaches will rant about this, right? They'll say, oh, God, we got to move the ball, guys. We can't punt the ball away. But they have to keep smiles off their faces, because that's the first time in the game they've had to do so. They've moved it quite well. They'll overall be happy with what they've seen.
So 2nd and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Now Fournette. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late 4th quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on 3rd?
I don't. I run the football, and I tell my offensive line, no leakage up front. I don't want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw, out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that.
The Jaguars on 3rd down. They've converted a 3rd of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This is 3rd and 8.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90. Hot. Hot.
Rudolph now to throw. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. I hate to surrender the football when you're nursing a slim lead, but they're going to have to punt it away. Trust that defense.
It's the right play at this stage of the game as well. You don't need to press it here, because you do have that little bit of a cushion, and you count on your D to make it stand up.
This is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. One possession game, time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive, because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he is across and in for the score. And now they can tie the game in the final stages with an extra point.
Or they can go for 2 and go for the win. Yes, it was a touchdown. And not just a TD, but how about a long touchdown that puts them in a great position now.
And now just an extra point away from tying this thing. And this is going to be recovered by the hand team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game. But these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for the Jags, they remain in the hunt for a first-round bye as they move to 11-3 on the year. And they will hit the road next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for the Redskins, this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. And they'll try to rebound next week on the road in Nashville. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.